So, as we know, today is a very special day, National Energy Conservation Day. And energy conservation can happen in multiple ways and all the nodes of electricity supply chain, as we understand. So, today we will try to focus more on the distribution side or the consumers, as we are knowing. With consumers, as we know, they are the key. So, we'll try to focus on this. And then, as Mr. Selvarajan mentioned about the initiative that we had taken for educating school children. So there is a video which is there already in the public domain. If time will permit, I'll try to play it, maybe 3-4 minutes video towards the end of the session. So welcome once again. We'll focus very, I have kept the slides very minimum in number. So overall, maybe 10 slides. And if you include the cover slides and all, 13 slides. So without much delay, let me start. Is my screen visible?
Yeah, it's visible, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay, right. So, as Dr. Selvarajan mentioned, I'm working with BSES, and BSES is a DISCOM, just like you have BESCOM in Bengaluru. BSES is in Delhi. So, this green portion is where the BSES Rajdhani serves, and Yamuna serves here. If you can see my icon, pointer, mouse pointer. So we together, BSES companies serve about 70% of the city of capital city of Delhi. It's in National Capital Territory region, not the NCR region. And these are some of the numbers. I will give you an idea about the size of the, and most important is like our consumer base. The consumer base is almost 86%, 85% is residential consumers like you and me. And it contributes to about 70% of the annual consumption. Number varies from year on year on. So primarily the residential consumer base is what I wanted to highlight. Then I'll move on to some of the initiatives that we have undertaken. But before that, I thought it will be very prudent. And please stop me if I'm being very technical. You can stop me anytime, any point of time, and ask any questions that you have. Now, I have tried to give you an analogy as to what do you mean by customer engagement pyramid. So it's not like the DISCOMs give you an electricity connection and there is a meter, somebody comes and reads the meter, gives you a bill and you pay the bill. That's it. No, it's not the case. There is more than it. So consumers are stakeholders. Now that we are talking about energy conservation, we are talking about consumers becoming prosumers. The consumers are more becoming a stakeholder, an equal partner with the DISCOMs. That's what the change in the entire thing is. And therefore, it is very, very important to understand scientifically how to engage with the customers. When we say customers, as you saw in the previous slide, in Delhi, for example, we have over 26 lakh metered connections. Okay, so how to engage with them? So it's not very easy. So technology has to play a very, very important role. The first thing is they start with the opt-out behavioral energy program. So behavioral energy program or behavioral energy efficiency program is a way and means. We did this POC, we'll talk about it later in the slide, in Delhi with 2 lakh residential consumers overall in South and West Delhi. This is about educating the consumers about their behavior, existing behavior, knowingly and unknowingly how they are consuming electricity throughout the day or maybe in a month or throughout the season, how do they behave. And then compare that behavior with their peers or neighborhoods. So scientifically, it has been proven that if there is a comparison between my behavior and my neighbor's behavior, and if I am able to judge that my neighbor is behaving in a much better way and leading to savings, I'll be more motivated to do so. So that is the scientifically proven fact, and it's not a conjecture. So basis that opt-out program means by default, the participating consumers are in. They'll be a participant of the program unless they choose to opt out of it. By default, they are in. So this also has a scientific base. So not many consumers, less than 1% of the consumers actually opt out because the benefits are huge. If you see here, no price, no device. That means you are not spending a single rupee. You're not installing a single device. Just by tweaking your behavior, you are able to achieve savings. And that is up to 1 to 2% of your annual billing or monthly billing. And if you talk about a DISCOM, this 1 to 2% of annual bill rate or annual bill units is humongous. huge. In case of, for example, Delhi in our area, this the potential is about 90 million units. So 90 million units, if you multiply by 5 rupees, which is the average power purchase cost, almost 55, 54 crores. So that is a huge money, and that is the saving for the entire consumer base. So those participating consumers who are participating in this program and leading to a saving of up to 1% or 2%, 54 crores, so they are also benefiting other consumers also, non-participating. And therefore, other non-participating consumers are also induced to participate and thereby double this impact. So that is the idea, behavior, and it includes delivery of the home energy reports, which is both a paper report as well as sent you on WhatsApp, as well as you have a web-based portal where you can log on to your portal and see your performance, maybe over the last 6 months, same period last year with your neighborhood, what is the kind of performance they are doing, or maybe energy efficient homes. So this is also now available on your mobile phones. That also services we have enabled. So this is also a portion called behavioral demand response. This is slightly different. What is this? So behavioral demand response is, we can send mobile alerts to the consumers on their mobile through this mobile app, saying that right now the tariff on the grid is on a higher side. Why don't you switch off your unused air conditioner or your unused, or maybe you can defer running your washing machine, or you defer running your OTG or microwave oven. So these simple tips, actually, we are not forcing you, but we are nudging you, saying that if you do so, in Delhi, for example, up to 200 units of consumption, if you're doing, you do not pay anything. So up to 200 units of consumption per month, the government is paying for you, subsidy. So if we are able to nudge you, saying that if you do this simple step of deferring or reducing, you'll be able to be within the bracket of 200 and thereby saving your bill. So this simple tip is able to motivate you to reduce the consumption or defer the consumption if you are a TOD tariff, time of day consumer. Second thing is, if you build on this, you drive to get more efficient, energy efficient products. Like, for example, energy efficient air conditioners. We'll talk about brushless DC motor fans, which is 27 watt fan compared to a typical 80 watt fan, AC fan that we have. Green tariff adoption. Now in Maharashtra, they have already notified green tariff. In Delhi, and in fact, Pan India, Ministry of Power has already floated as draft paper for green tariff. Distributed energy resources, DER, that is rooftop solar, or even EV charging. So you can install rooftop solar and lessen your bills by reducing your dependence on the grid by net metering or even by net billing. So that is also going to help you in saving your bill, because this is one time. And of course, the Ministry of New Renewable Energy is providing you CAPEX subsidy. And in many states, the states are offering matching subsidy. In Delhi, for example, they are offering generation-based incentive. That is, every unit of solar produced, they are giving you 2 rupees per unit kind of incentive in Delhi, for example. So the enrollment in load control programs, or we say demand response programs, time-varying rates or TOD rates. In fact, it could be time of use rates also, hourly rates also, which is going to come very soon. And so these are the programs where you actually spend money, but then the payback period is very, very small. So for example, in Delhi, residential sector, if you invest in rooftop solar, your payback period is hardly 2 to 3 years. The life is 25 years. So balance 22, 23 years, you are literally having solar energy for free. Okay. And that is forever, for those 23 years, it's going to reduce your dependence on the grid and thereby reduce the electricity bill that you have. The next is promote the energy management automation. So this is a high level. So the top of the pyramid, for example, smart homes or smart industries or smart hotels, building automation. So where or maybe vehicle to grid. So these become a reliable grid resources, which are visible to the DSO or DISCOM. For example, there is a hospital which is having a, say, 1 megawatt or 500 kilowatt battery storage. Now that battery storage is otherwise helping the hospital having UPS kind of supply, but this is also being controlled by a DISCOM, and depending upon the grid needs, it can discharge or charge the battery. So that is a grid resource. So this is an additional income source for the hospital. That is a C&I consumer, commercial and industrial consumer. Similarly, there is a huge parking lot. For example, in Bangalore at airport, you have a huge parking lot. Now, a particular floor or maybe two or three floors reserved for electric vehicles or vehicles are parked there and already charged. Huge battery bank is there. That battery bank can be utilized by BESCOM saying that, okay, you pump the electricity during this hour to this hour because at that point in time, we need power. And the batteries would have been charged some point other time in the day when there was enough sunshine or maybe in the night. So that is vehicle to grid. This thing is also coming up. So this is a community storage project. So these are the resources which will provide energy management automation. So hope I was able to explain to you the concept of engaging with the consumer, starting from no price, no device, to having some kind of investment for individual level, and then at the community level, the grid level or community level. Okay. Now I'll move on to more focus on the behavioral energy efficiency program that we did, home energy report program, as we say. Now, this home energy report is very similar to your electricity bill. Okay. This talks about how you have fared over the last month, comparison to your neighbor, comparison to energy efficient homes. What could have you done better to save more? How much you would have saved in terms of rupee? What are the tips if you had to follow to save that much amount? So one pager, but very crisp and giving you all these things and also your past 6 months consumption, same period last year and this year also, comparison between yourself, your neighbors and energy efficient homes, those who are doing very good. Now, these are communication channels. One is the HER, as I said, hard copy. Apart from that, soft copy through WhatsApp. Then there is something called mails. Mails are also being sent. Now there is a saving of almost 1 to 2% in the peak hours also, as well as otherwise energy also. Now this particular home energy program was rolled out in October 2018 and covered almost 2 lakh consumers across 10 divisions of BSES. A recent report by Niti Aayog released on 3rd August 2021 also, which is titled Turning Around the Power Distribution Sector, also appreciated this program and said that this should be replicated across the utilities across India, especially the urban centers, where people would appreciate such kind of, and they have the huge consumption also. This mentions about the pilot project that we did and also about the advantages. Next one is, this is called Energy Wise Energy Rise program. So you can see from the picture, so this program is focused on the government schools here in Delhi. Class 6 to class 8 children are there. And the three pillars of this EWER program, together with TERI, the Energy Research Institute, we have partnered with them, is pollution and its mitigation. Second is energy efficiency. And third is renewable energy. So on these three aspects, we created some material for them. You can see from the pictures also, students are having some materials and booklets. They are doing all the activities here, to-do activity, because only books are not sufficient. So we devised some activities which are easy to understand. They also did energy audit of their homes. So they had that capability. We trained them that they could do the energy audit of their homes also. And this started in 2019. Okay, the approval came in March 2018 and it started in 2019. 90,000 students across 300 government schools were covered. Okay, 2 years, these many students, schools and these many students were covered. Third year, that was last year, was due to COVID, it was suspended. And we had developed certain online modules also. So this year, when the government schools have reopened now, probably the government will now allow, we are before the government and they might allow us to resume the program. And we are expanding this to other areas of Delhi as well. So this is a very focused program where we say that the children become our messenger. So I'll just show you a video after this particular PPT is over, which will give you a glimpse about it. Next, we have already worked upon how can the residential consumer benefit from the time of use rate from the residential consumers, right? So some of the findings are over here, and this was done with the help of National Renewable Energy Agency, NREL, Laboratory, Department of Energy, Government of United States, and we did it together through research work, survey of the residential consumer and C&I customer. So there is a case where we see that there is value to the residential consumer if we offer them a TOD rate. It's not always true that TOD rate will, impact the residential consumer in an adverse way. It will increase their bill. It's not like that. Keeping the existing bill of the consumer within the same amount, how can the residential consumer be benefited from a reduced rate in the off-peak period and pay at the rate of marginal cost of electricity being procured by the DISCOM? And this we have also proposed for EV charging, electric vehicle charging in Delhi. For example, we launched a single window scheme in EV charging, the link of which it is already there in public domain. You as a consumer in Delhi, you can apply for an EV charger plus an EV metered connection, 2-in-1 through a single window. And it will be delivered to your home and connected, etc., within 10 working days. So 7 to 10 working days, depending upon the type of connection, the type of charges you have asked for. So this window we had started in November 8th. Now, apart from this, there is a ADR POC that we did, automated demand response. So consumers otherwise are willing to participate in such kind of programs. That's what we found out from the survey. And here what we did was through usage of the smart plug, that is the middle of the pyramid. If you remember the pyramid, the middle of the pyramid. Through the smart plugs, we were able to control the temperature set point of the air conditioner remotely. So for example, you are running an AC at say 20 degrees Celsius. For 15 minutes or half an hour, we increase the temperature from 20 degree to maybe 22 degree or 23 degree Celsius. It was hardly noticeable by the consumer, but then she incurred a lot of savings. But every degree Celsius increase in temperature leads to about 5 to 6% energy savings. This is the finding that we already have. So this we were able to do so. And the measurement and verification was done through a smart agent, which was connected to the meter. And otherwise non-smart meter. And now we are connecting smart meters anyway, so that is not a problem. So this initiative actually, when we did, was also beneficial for the consumers. Why? Because they were earning out of it. When they participated, they got some benefit sharing as well. While reducing their bill, on top of it, they were also getting benefits without compromising on their comfort, for example. Now, second thing was we also time shifted the geyser load in the winter. So for example, if you are waking up at 6 p.m., you want hot water at 6 p.m., you do not need to switch on the geyser at 6 a.m. only. So what we did was, while you were asleep, through your home Wi-Fi or other and or cellular connection, we actually switched, staggered the geyser timing. So 4 a.m. we switched on the geyser for half an hour, and the water was hot for next 3 hours. That was depending upon the capacity of the a particular geyser. So when you woke up and went to the bathroom was ready with your hot water. And that point in time, not everybody was switching on the geyser. Therefore, the load was reduced without any discomfort to the consumer. So such things are possible through a coordinated fashion by a DISCOM, because DISCOM has an idea as to what is the overall scenario of the overall load in that particular residential area. One single consumer might not have, but overall DISCOM will have an idea whether the distribution transformer is getting overloaded or not. So there is a huge response. You can see here 62% of the surveyed residential consumers, they agreed to participate in such kind of demand response program. And the potential is huge. If you see in Delhi, even if 1 kilowatt relief is provided by one consumer, there is huge potential. There is a conceptual video also here. The link is already, this PPT is already shared with you. You can watch at your leisure. Then there is an AC replacement scheme. So all 5-star AC. The survey was done some years back. We found out that over 50% of the air conditioners, they are all 3-star ACs. And that is a huge potential. So 5-star ACs have a huge potential of reducing the consumption. So subsidies were rolled out under the regulatory program, saying that, okay, depending upon the energy saving capability of the AC, why can't you invest? And then payback period for this is about 4 to 5 years. And the AC is guaranteed initially for 5 years. Then you can also purchase the AMC. Normally, the 5-star ACs do not get phased out by at least 10 years. For at least 10 years, they are serviceable. Though they are 5-star rating, actually today, which is 5-star, maybe next year it will become 4-star. Or 2 years down the line, it will become 4-star. But still, the 5-star ACs which are now getting produced are very energy efficient, like inverter air conditioners, which are very, very much energy efficient compared to the previous one. So these are some of the findings, like 1003.64 units, actual savings were observed. And in 2019, it was 955.59 over the entire season, over the entire heating season. So 100% buyback arrangement, we destroyed the old ACs in an environment friendly manner by disposing of the gas, the cooling gas, which is filled inside it, and also destroying the compressor, reuse principles also, a certified agency. So the idea is to completely save the environment. Next is the, I think there is a fan scheme, the BLDC fan. So nowadays you can order on Amazon. In fact, the prices are slightly higher on Amazon. For example, an Atomberg, or there are two or three more brands, will cost you about, say, 3,000 rupees or about 3,200 rupees a piece. And these are all brushless DC fans with 27 watt compared to 80 watts in a conventional AC fan you have. Don't require any regulator here. You simply have a remote, and through remote, you can control the fan speed. You can time the fan switching on, switching off, and you can go to sleep mode by gradually while the fan speed gets down. So all these kind of things are there. You can program the fan also through the simple remote is there. So these kind of fans, actually, we offered under, this is already under offer, subsidy. So that 3,000 rupee fan is almost about 1,700 rupee, and normal AC fan, good brand, is about 1,000 to 1,200 rupee. We are still seeing that how we can bring this fan out at equivalent price to a AC fan or alternate current fan. These are some of the salient features. Power consumption 27 to 28 watt, 1,200 mm sweep. This is the normal fan that we have. 3-year on-site replacement warranty, smart remote. And this is the discount applicable in Delhi only. Voltage fluctuation is not an issue here. There is no humming noise, quite noiseless fan. And there is no heating of the fan compared to the AC fan, for example. So I myself am a user of such fan, BLDC fan, for the past 3 summer seasons now. And I'm quite happy. So I converted all my fans. I replaced them and with a BLDC fan. So this also is very, very important. If you see here, in Delhi, for example, you have 25 lakhs homes in our area, and every home will have at least one fan, at least one fan. So, and each fan, suppose you are reducing the consumption from 80 watt to 27 or 28 watt, reduction of at least 50 watt. So 50 watt into 27 lakhs. So that is the kind of megawatt benefits, and it runs into, say, 200, 300 megawatts only for BRPL area, because the fans run for 10 hours or 12 hours a day during the summers, for example. So during peak hour also they are running. So theoretically, if you are able to transform or change the entire lot, there is a saving of about 200 megawatt, and for Delhi it could be 500 megawatt. Huge, huge respite. So that is, you see the potential. So therefore, the government is also convinced that why don't we promote such kind of brands and bring it under to the doorsteps of the consumer. So you go to a Kirana shop, you go to your neighborhood friendly store, he should also have these kind of fans. Visibility should be there at a rate which is comparable to your AC fans, etc. So that is the idea that we need to float, that we have already floated. This was floated about 3 years back, and we see a lot of traction. We have tried to tie up with the builders, where when they are constructing new property, we are saying that you equip the new property only with the BLDC fan, not the AC fans. And also retrofit, you allow retrofit and bring out some kind of good buyback schemes that we have brought out in the city of Delhi. So this also we have proposed to Bureau of Energy Efficiency, that why don't you take it up on a massive or large scale throughout the country. So this will also save a lot of energy for our country. as we go forward to reduce coal consumption and also increase RE penetration. So these are some of the initiatives that we have taken. Like Dr. Selvarajan was talking about the launch of BRPL Solar City Initiative in Dwarka area. That was in January 2018. And these are some of the pictures from that event that happened. And after that, we haven't looked back. So we had so many sessions with, and thanks to Dwarka and Federation and the RWAs, we have done a lot of session with them on how DSM is important, how solar is important, how solar can help you reduce the bill. And RESCO mode and CAPEX mode both are available. So it's very easy to go solar in BESCOM, I think area also, you can go solar in a very easy way. MNRE subsidies are available. This is the journey so far. So if you see in January 2018, in fact, somewhere here we were 21 megawatt and we have now grown up to 90 megawatt. So almost 70 megawatt in the last 4 years, thanks to our consumers over here. You see the number of consumers mostly is residential. 60% is residential only. But since the ticket size of each of the residential consumer is low, so the contribution in residential is only 22% in terms of the capacity. But that doesn't matter at all because the distributed solar also helps in reduction of the bill of the individual consumer. And anyway, residential consumer, if we solarize, that is also helpful for the DISCOM. It is a win-win proposition. Though some of the DISCOM say that, no, it's very, very difficult for us. Solar is eating away our revenue. But we are saying that if you solarize the residential consumer, it will not eat away your revenue. It is going to be beneficial both for the consumer as well as for the DISCOM. Now, this is a long, long slide. So you can read through it. There are 30 tips we have given might find useful. Day-to-day life, you can use them and to save electricity bills. Very simple and easy to follow tips, which you can read through. And normally, yes, they are very much doable. They're very much practical. Okay. Now, one more thing is in the behavioral energy efficiency program that we did, we provide very customized tips. Customized tips means we request the consumers to actually, just a second, I'll plug on my adapter. It is running out of the battery. So in the home energy program, what we did was we asked the consumers to take a survey. So survey would ask you like how many appliances do you have, what are their ratings, usually what are the timings that you run your appliances, etc., etc. Based upon that, we give very customized feedback. So customized tips. You need not go through all the 30 tips. So in that program, we give you very customized, you do this. And if you do this much is the saving in rupee terms you'll be having. But overall, since I don't know about your individual preferences, etc., so these are some of the tips which could be helpful for you in your day-to-day life. And these are available with you and you can refer to later. So thank you for your patience and time. And Dr. Selvarajan, if you allow, should I play that video?
Yeah, please continue. And, we can see the video also. May I request Mr. Krishna Kumar to mute himself because it's not getting muted. I'm just trying to mute him. I'm not able to mute. Mr. Kumar, kindly mute yourself. Shall I mute everyone and then I will unmute the chief guest. One second. Please, because I think he must have forgotten. I'll mute all.
Yeah, so am I audible now and can I
now? Yeah, you please go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. Let me know if you are able to hear the video. Okay.
Okay.
एनर्जी सेव करी तभी तो हमें आज इस एनर्जी मिल रहा है बट हमारी जो आगे वाली जनरेशन है अगर हम उनके लिए एनर्जी सेव नहीं करेंगे तो वो बेचारे कैसे रहेंगे
BSAS is committed to providing clean, green and sustainable energy to the consumers. So, but that is not what we are only limited to. So, as we know that electricity touches all our lives. So, we are also trying to touch the lives of our consumers in more than one way. Electricity is just one of them.
We at Terry are absolutely delighted to partner with BSES on the Energy Wise Energy Rise program. This program seeks to strengthen outreach to school students regarding renewables, water conservation, waste management, and we are reaching out to about 90,000 students over 3 years. And it helps provide information on clean and affordable energy, essentially SDG 7. To students, it imprints it in their minds today so that they can act accordingly tomorrow.
बच्चों को इस प्रोजेक्ट के वजह से बहुत सारी जानकारियाँ मिली हैं कि बिजली को कैसे बचाना चाहिए। अब इस प्रोजेक्ट की वजह से बच्चों को पता चलने लग गया है कि अच्छा इनका बिजली का बिल इतना आता है। जब वर्कशॉप स्टार्ट हुआ एनर्जी राइज एनर्जी वाइज का तो बच्चे बहुत बहुत खुश थे इस प्रोजेक्ट को लेके। बच्चों ने जब बुक्स देखी थी तो बच्चे बड़े एक्साइटेड थे। बच्चों को ये बुक्स इतनी अट्रैक्टिव और इतनी अच्छी लगी हैं कि बच्चों ने पूरी बुक रीड की है।
एनर्जी वाइज एनर्जी राइज का मतलब है कि एनर्जी यानी कि ऊर्जा का इस बुद्धिमत्ता से उपयोग किया जाए कि वो सिर्फ हमारी ही नहीं आने वाली जनरेशन की भी आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति कर सके।
एक पोस्ट असेसमेंट भी था कि हमें बताना है कि हमारे घर में कितना हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंजर्व कर रहे हैं, और एक हमने उसमें भरा था कि वन डे हम कितना कंजप्शन कर रहे हैं, हमारी कितनी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी लग रही है और मंथली कितना कर रहे हैं।
बच्चों का जो रिव्यू था और एक्साइटमेंट थी इस वर्कशॉप को अटेंड करने के लिए वो बहुत ही ज़्यादा थी।
बच्चों के लिए बड़ी नई चीज़ थी एनर्जी वाइज एनर्जी राइज, और उन्होंने बड़े इसको पॉजिटिव वे में लिया।
हमारे बच्चों में अवेयरनेस आई और मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि बच्चों ने एनर्जी के प्रति जागरूकता आई है और बच्चे अवेयर हो गए बहुत ज़्यादा।
इस प्रोग्राम को आप जन जन तक पहुँचाएं और जन जन तक पहुँचना चाहिए।
वी आर ऑल वेरी कॉन्शियस ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट मदर अर्थ इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू अस एंड द impact of climate changes is affecting each and every individual. This problem is going to become more acute as we are going forward. So therefore we feel that energy wise energy rise will bring this knowledge and awareness and will raise the consciousness to make the efforts towards energy conservation.
Thanks a lot for watching, and now over to you.
Yeah, I think now we can go for the question hour. Any person can unmute yourself and ask the questions. You are able to unmute? Not able to unmute means then I will have to do that one. I don't know.
Sir, this is Shikhar. Can I ask a query?
Yeah, sure, sir. Sure, please. Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Alok Ranjan, for a brilliant presentation and telling us how to save energy at our home. Just one quick query. Does BSES provide some kind of a survey of home through which we can reduce our energy reduction?
Yes, this is called first of all, for example, under solar program, we do that. Second is behavioral energy efficiency program that we did. There also, there is a survey that we do. And third is the ESCO services, for example. So that also services there. As a DISCOM, we provide these services to the consumer. For example, BEE, that is behavioral energy efficiency program we did initially, that was funded by a pilot, but now we have a post commission that it should be regularized for all the consumers in Delhi.
And how can we approach the BSES for getting it done for our respective homes?
Essential homes, you mean?
For our home, for our house or apartment.
Apartment. You can raise the request in, there is a consumer portal, BSESdelhi.com, or on the helpline, you can say that you want an energy audit of your respective homes. We'll try to, we have the empaneled auditors also through BEE, Bureau of Energy Efficiency.
Okay.
So they will offer the services. There is one baseline audit, which is preliminary audit, which might not cost you. We'll have to find out. But if you want a detailed audit, so that pricing as of now will be decided. Of course, we will guide them, but finally the prices will have to be decided by you and the auditor.
Got it. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for answering my queries.
Welcome, sir.
Mr. Abhishek, if we can do this energy auditing from our side, from Green Circle, I would like to undertake this work through our volunteers. They can do this one, going home to home, and they can do that one.
Why not? We can do that.
So
what you can do is, my team is there. I'll pass on the email ID of my team member separately to you. And you can evince your interest that as an audit kind of thing you can do. And we'll see what kind of accreditation you have or those people have in BEE or otherwise also. So why not? We can do that.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much. Any other question, please?
Sir, I'm Rakhi Jain this side. Can I ask a question, sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, I live in a place where it is a DDA apartment in Saket. So if I want to go for a solar for my portion, which is I'm on the ground floor, so it will be convenient and easily possible because the terrace is a common terrace for all of us.
Okay.
We are three, like ground floor, first floor, and second floor. So the terrace becomes common.
No, so who is having the terrace rights on the paper?
Nobody, sir. It's a DDA flat. Straight staircase going to the terrace. So it's a common terrace.
Okay, so that is not a problem. See, we always have, now we already have a VNM virtual net metering also. So for example, the terrace is common. All three of you agree that boss, we'll have a rooftop solar over there. So the direct benefit can be passed on to your respective individual bills also. Earlier, it was not possible.
Okay,
so that is also possible. So okay, if at all only you are interested and other two are not interested, then possibly you'll have to get an NOC from Matat that, okay, they don't have any objection because this is a common terrace. And therefore, you can go and get the solar done over there. That is the proof of address that is required. Otherwise, what happens is, later on, these people will say, no, this is common terrace. How could you get the solar installed?
Yeah, I understand. Why create disputes for future? Yeah, it's better to take it on record.
Yeah. So you take an NOC and you submit, and why not? You can go for it.
Thank you very much, sir. So there I have another...
There is a website called solarbses.com. Maybe I'll write here.
Solarbses.com.
Solarbses.com. Okay. So this is, I have typed in my chat box. So this will give you the information about what is available in solar. Also, you can evince your interest on this website. When you log on to the website, you will see evince your interest, you refer your CN number, etc. Then my people, the team will contact you automatically. You don't have to go anywhere. And once you decide, you can submit your application also online on this portal only. No need to go anywhere.
Okay. Right, sir. Thank you very much. So I had another query. I have a government school next to our block. So I don't know whether all schools have been covered, but if my HOS is interested, like I am part of the school management committee. So if I can bring it up for my school, and if my HUS is ready to do this program, Energy Wise, Energy Rise, whom do I contact, sir, in BSES?
Yeah, so my colleague is there, Mr. Avinash Kumar. Let me see. I'll pass on his number to Selvarajan ji.
Okay, sir.
Selvarajan ji, you can pass on the number to Ms. Rakhi Jain.
I'll do that one.
Yeah. So he's coordinating with Terry. So we, as I said, the third phase is yet to start because of the COVID. Okay. It couldn't happen.
Okay.
So let me see if that can be included, because we obtained permission from Department of Education, Government of Delhi, for the school. So this is a government school, madam?
Yes, sir. It is Ishani Government School in G Block, Saket. And there's another government school in J Block, Saket. So we have
That is not a problem. It has to be government school.
Yeah, it is a Delhi government school. These two are Delhi government schools. In fact, Ishani is run in two shifts. So there's morning and evening. It's girls in the morning and boys in the evening. And we can club them together if a program can be done.
Why not? So you can share these details, and we'll request Terry to include this in their application to the DOE. And once they obtain the approval, these two schools can also be included.
Because I think the children, if they participate, it is very essential for the community and our country for future, actually. So it would be very nice. Very nice initiative, sir, this Energy Rise one. Thank you so much.
What I'll do is...
Good evening, sir. This is Rangarajan this side.
Yes, sir.
This little noisy outing. Please forgive me for that. I have two questions. Number one, particularly for people holding the top floors, where the exposure to sun is very high during summertime, is there any work which BSES has done where the radiation effect can be brought down with your research, number one?
Mm.
Second part, I work in a school, and we have a solar panel plant which is being laid out. Is there any tie-up with the horticultural department and BSES so that the shadow from trees in the neighborhood can be cut down from this thing? Is there any link like that? Is it possible for you to share some information on that?
Okay, the first question first. You talked about what is the research work done in to ensure that the roof is not absorbing the solar energy, but it is reflecting back. So one is, we have already started at installation of solar panel on the roof. So this will cool down your roof anyway and reduce the cooling requirement for the top floor. And it will also produce electricity for you. So that solar initiative is already there. If you're interested, you can participate. And if you are not willing, and there are raised structures also, you do not need to waste your roof also. 9 feet raised structure, you can install the panels. And beneath the panels, you can sit, enjoy, relax, and use your roof. That is also possible. Second thing, this is already operational. The information you can find on solarbases.com. There are,
yes,
in the help section, you go there, you have these options.
Okay, sir.
And second thing is, you spoke about cutting down of the trees. Now, the cutting out of the trees, horticulture or Department of Environment, they are responsible. So, it depends upon case to case. We don't have any such MOU to cut down the trees. In fact, that will not be allowed, I think. But yes, some pruning of the trees, some branches, etc., depending upon case to case. Suppose your home is there and there is some shadow effect. So, that will depend upon the survey done. And if, as per the survey, some pruning of trees will help save some of the space, that can be done. So this is possible once you do the survey of the exact property, and then the shadow result is available. Based upon that, decision can be taken. But of course, we don't have any tie-up with any horticulture department
only
to cut down the trees.
I mean only pruning the trees, not cutting the trees, sir.
Yeah.
Because from two different sides, because of the shadow, almost we are getting exposure of 4 hours, getting restricted to some of the layers. So why don't you
have you applied for solar on Solar BSES portal?
We got it installed through some private player.
Okay.
And it is
okay.
Already operational, and it is bringing lot of drop in the energy which is there being used in the school.
Hmm.
But still, this shadow aspect, I want to take the help of BSES if possible, because it comes in a residential area, sector 4 RKpuram.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to reach the horticulture department, and they are just stalling the things and saying you approach SDMC.
Because here in this case, since the solar is already installed and there is a shadow, etc., So yeah. Trees and parks, etc., they are being mentored either by DDA or MCD depending upon the location.
Okay.
And that is why they are asking you to go to MCD. Probably that park where the tree is belongs to MCD, STMC.
Can so BSEs intervene on this? That is what I would like to
know. Frankly speaking, I'll have to find out, but prima facie, I don't think so. Because we are not, had it been some kind of pruning, etc., like for example.
Only pruning I want.
No, actually, sir, pruning is not permitted to the individual societies or the schools. You need to go to MCD or you need to go to DDA, and they might have got the blanket permission to do some pruning. Otherwise, I think Delhi Preservation of Tree Act is there, in which you are not permitted to do individually. You have to go by SDMC or, you know, in municipality or DDA. I think you must go by Delhi Preservation of Tree Act is there. Please go through it.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
So can I just add here on sir's question, Mr. Rangarajan, if I'm not wrong. So there is an app, SDMC app 311. If you'll put it there, this is taken on priority if it is blocking any light or solar panel or CCTV cameras, because I keep doing it for my block very often. I'm an RWA representative as well. So that should help. And even if that doesn't help, there is an LG portal. So we use all these apps to get our work done. And if it is an online complaint, it is addressed on priority. So maybe you can use that.
Yeah, it's on SDMC portal with 311.
311, SDMC 311. When you'll go to your Play Store and you start looking for apps, you'll see SDMC 311. So you can download that. There's also an LG listening portal. Lieutenant Governor. So you can use these apps and they really help. Things happen
great,
very
ma'am.
Fast.
Great, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Welcome, sir.
It's going to help us a lot. Thank you.
Welcome, sir.
Okay. Any other questions, sir? Otherwise, we can wind up. Before that, I would like to request anyone, if they are having any question, please do ask.
Sir, a Dwarka-specific question can be posed?
Yeah, please.
How many group housing societies have you been able to go ahead with solar plants in Dwarka?
I think, if I am not mistaken, about 100 societies have been already solarized over the past 3-4 years. And last year was a slight dampener because of the COVID situation. The AGMs could not be held because annual general meeting approval is necessary. So last year it was a dampener. Otherwise, Dwarka has been a very good area for us to solarize. And still there are so many societies, we are hoping to solarize them again. This tender, solar tender, has got over 3rd of October this year. So right now we are in process of floating another tender. As per the MNRG sanction, that should be over by January. So, and hopefully if this third wave is not there, we should have a very good year next year.
Do we have still subsidy in place for
solar? Yes. Yes, we do have. We do have. MNRG Central Financial Assistance, MNRG subsidy up to 40% for the up to 3 kilowatt and 20% for the 3 to 10 kilowatt. That is there.
We in Sudharpunj apartment, it is in Sector 7, are trying to get solar done, but there has not been much headway. So, in case required, can we contact you, sir?
No, definitely. So, who has been you have been contacting till date? How did you manage?
We have not gotten contact with the BACS, but we have been in contact with certain vendors.
No. For you, we have made the life easy, no, sir? What you do is you go to solar BSE. Let me show you that. That is very easy. Why do you want to waste your time and effort on vendors? And that is the whole process why government has come out with this. Let me share this screen with you. And therefore, this portal, just hold on. Can you see this webpage of mine?
Yes.
Okay. What you need to do is, once you log on to the solarbss.com, this is the page which will open. You simply click express interest and you just write here those things, right? Along with your copy of electricity bill you can upload and your CA number.
Okay.
And submit. One pager. That's it. It takes maybe 5 minutes, not more than that.
Okay. This would be for the group housing society itself.
Yeah, everybody. residential, right. Commercial, institutional, industrial, others. You just type residential.
Residential.
Okay. So then what will happen is people will come to you and ask, sir, what can we do for you?
Right.
And apart from this, you can see my FAQs, yeah, downloads, etc. Right? So if you go to FAQs, you have these different documents, what do you need, what not, etc. And then you go to downloads, there is a complete solar booklet for you.
Okay? Right.
Now, apart from the booklet, here we have the list of vendors also, empanel vendors. Mm-hmm. Okay. And this is the leaflet also. Okay. Rates, vendor for CAPEX mode and the RESCO mode. But now these are now obsolete because the tender came to an end of 3rd of October. That is why I'm asking. This scheme was there for the last 2 years. So you could have availed that. As low as 2200 per kilowatt here, 22,200 per kilowatt peak and 3 rupees 9 paise per unit flat, RESCO mode. For RESCO mode, minimum 25 kilowatt of solar is required and you could have gone for it. So that's why I'm wondering. So you couldn't, because we had done so many sessions. Anyway, no problem. You can go through them. You'll have some idea.
Certainly, I will go through them and if required, we'll get back, sir.
Yeah, yeah, why not? And these are, for example, solar help decks is there. Yeah. These are email IDs, phone, solar helpline, and grievance redressal mechanism also, the hierarchy, etc. is given over here. And once this, again, the net metering subsidy scheme is back, you can apply from here, no? You can register and apply. In fact, your vendor can apply.
Vendor.
You choose the vendor and the vendor can apply, take care of all the technical details. A vendor can be anyone empaneled by us or maybe your private vendor also, anybody. So, but why, sir, you were not able to, I mean, you had your AGM and you have already approved solar?
We have approved it in our AGM in principle, but mm-hmm. there are certain other issues which are coming up. So that mm-hmm. is why we can do it in a group housing societies. There are a variety of actors and some going in different directions. So that is natural.
So you need to have some proposals, techno-commercial proposals. They can be presented before the AGM and you can debate on actual numbers, benefits, costs, etc., etc. And that is the natural process. That's how the residential societies will go on. You will have several kind of actors and actresses. There's no problem. But then there are ways and means to convince them. So they also get convinced. We have to be very patient and we have to be perseverant. So that's right. What we have learned over the past 4 years. We have to be very patient and we have to serve the consumers with great humility and patience. Without patience, nobody will be able to, they will not be able to persuade somebody.
Very good.
So consistent building is very important.
Very good. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Welcome, sir.
So, well, I think if there are no more questions, we can complete this session. I must thank Mr. Abhishek Ranjan for a wonderful session. You know, I know that he was completely tired today. I know from his face, I can understand. You know, he was having lots of meetings and we had to postpone it from 7:30 to 8 o'clock just to accommodate him because he was so busy today. Whole day was busy and a very... we are really lucky to have a very brilliant officer in BSES who can coordinate with lots of, associations, schools and other things. We will definitely make use of your services in future also. And we will have that energy audit, this program for through Green Circle also will do some energy audit so that it will be nice for everyone. You know, it will be easy. We are reachable to the people so we can... easily make use of the, we can have a via media between the department and the people, that we can do it. So thank you so much, sir, for your wonderful lecture on this thing. Very crisply you have done completed everything in that time. I wish to have a longer session for our people who want to know more about the conservation and all these things. Today, I think we have celebrated the National Energy Conservation Day in a very fitting manner with Mr. Abhishek Ranjan, who was handling the session very brilliantly. We are obliged to you. We are thankful to you. Let's look forward to have more association with you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Selva, sir, and everybody for this honor. And we look forward to serve everybody in this capacity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It was very fruitful session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Look forward to many more like this, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everyone, for your
time.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you. Happy Energy Conservation Day.